Hello, my name is Joseph and I am the founder of Gentleman's Armor. Together, we'll explore the world of tradition, craftsmanship and quality. In today's video, we're going to talk about American suit style, when it started, which company brought it up, and we will analyze the characteristics of the American traditional suit. Before we begin, please take a moment and subscribe to our channel, leave a comment and press the like button. It really gives us the strength to continue and explore the world of tradition, craftsmanship and quality. When someone listens the words sack suit, it goes straight to his mind that something related to a sack, for example a sack of potatoes. The truth is that this may have been in the mind of the one who designed it, but basically, even though at the beginning everyone demoted and mocked it, on many occasions eventually everyone had at least one in their wardrobe for various occasions, for a picnic in the countryside or a visit to a church on Sunday. It was accepted by people of either low social class or high social class. Of course, for different purposes each. That some gentlemen used it as a casual suit that they would dare to wear in some parties with friends or in some bad weather conditions, while some others of a lower social class had it as an official garment for Sundays. Jackets without darts, or as they are popularly known, sack suits, first appeared in France in the mid-19th century, back when men's formal and frock jackets had backs made of four curved panels. This clean front and back French sack jacket was something original and unique, but also easy and quick to make. Its name has two versions of origin. One is from the French word sack, and the other from straight hanging drap. So as can anyone understand, this cut is one of the oldest forms of suit making, but at the same time, it is the way that contributed and helped in the manufacture of tailoring and which eventually later became the traditional American style of suit making. Following a straight line cut and to not represent a specific body, we can say that it suits to all men's body types, of course after some small alterations for each one. First of all, we all know that America loves equality, so American suits are made for everyone. The well-known American sack suit was first released on the market at the beginning of the 20th century by Brooks Brothers, which was the first company to introduce its mass production to cover men's needs. Regarding the manufacture of ready-to-wear men's suit, it is noticeable that they have focused at the mass production of suits, resulting in their manufacture in a square shape without curves so that they can be adapted to any body type. What we should emphasize is that the construction of the suit is related to the body type of each man individually, and it is obvious that some physical imperfections should be weakened and hidden, and the strong points of the body should be highlighted in the best way. So the right tailor should know your figure very well in order to make the right suit for you. Having that in mind, we can easily understand that the revolution of the time for ready-to-wear suit was something unreal, and was easily loved by the consumers. The invention of the American suit became particularly popular and beloved, and the first to embrace the style were Evil Inges, who uniquely combined it with loafers. As college kids, they liked to be different from the crowd, so it quickly became fashionable for them. And now it was commonly accepted that college kids used to wear this type of suits, as adults used to dress more elegantly. After the end of the Second World War, there is an increase in the popularity of the sack suit, probably due to the hardships they went through during the war and the desire to place it in their wardrobes. After the mid-20th century, the sack suit was the dominant ready-to-wear suit style. Even many companies that made bespoke suits were forced to use this technique and now sell ready-to-wear suits. We notice that in the American suit, there is enough space around the waist, and there are no darts in the canvas. This has the result that the line of the jacket does not follow the body of the wear, but has a straighter and boxier character. We can also point out that the armpits are lower than other styles, and the pockets have flaps. Unlike the other types of suits, what becomes distinct is the construction of the shoulder. As in this type, there is no padding to add structure, and their texture is soft, while the other types of suits, like the British style, we find a completely different situation with structured shoulders and padding. Another characteristic we found in the American sack suit is the tailoring of the vent, which located on the back of the suit on the underside, are made of one vent. American suit style features also include buttoning the shirt collar, wearing a wool tie with loafers, and using belts in preference to suspenders. The American style of suiting adapted as necessary the use of three buttons on suits. This construction method is a classic and conservative choice, and its use becomes more evident in the most everyday situations. We should emphasize that there are two types of adding the top button to the jacket. The first is by placing the lapel roll over the top button, while the second by wrapping the top button in the lapel roll. In the first case, the top two buttons of the jacket are buttoned, while in the second, only the middle one. We should note that in both cases, the lowest button is always unbuttoned. In terms of body type, we could conclude that there is no specific type that can support the American suit, as it is suitable for everyone, regardless the weight or height. What is needed is each man's personal style adapted appropriately and combined with a specific occasion to achieve an harmonious, balanced effect. Modernizing the era, we notice that the traditional sack suit has now lost its luster. It can now be said that the American style of suit making has taken many of the basic elements found in other styles and has managed to make one of its own, which includes the mix of English and Italian styles.